Hello everybody, my name is Jeremy and welcome to my channel. I want to talk about Project Runway season 16, episode 10. This is another unconventional challenge and we are in the top six now, which is absolutely freaking crazy. I haven't been reviewing most of the season just because I haven't really found time, but in the last episode we had, I'm pretty sure, the first DQ in all of Project Runway and then a double elimination, which three designers out all in the same episode is quite frankly just insane to me. When the episode started, I called it that I thought that Tim was going to use his Tim Gun safe because they were talking about it so much, or at least Michael was, and then on the runway, Heidi made a very big point to be like, hey Tim, remember that Tim Gun save that you haven't used all season? Remember how you haven't used that? You could totally use that at any point because we're in the top six and like, now's the time to do it. So I thought he was going to, but then he ended up not, which I'm not mad about. So the out person tonight was Michael, which I'm, again, not mad about. The outfit that he created was with intention, and it did not look good. It was something the judges have very vocally stated over several seasons that they don't like. They don't like that hookery type of look, and they don't really like bondage. Like, it's just not their cup of soup. So I was not surprised that he went home, literally at all. And I think if it had been Kentaro that had gone home, I think Tim would have used the save, because I'm pretty sure that Tim is using, or saving it, for Kentaro, Brandon, or Ayana. If he uses it on Kenya or Margarita, I'd be shocked, frankly. Ayana is the one who won tonight's episode, and rightfully freaking so, because her outfit was stunning from top to bottom, and Margarita had some giant lady balls to be saying that she didn't like it and that it didn't look good, because it looked amazing. It looked like she created a leather jacket, and then all the stoning that she did, and the way that she created that sparkle, the way that it like went all the way down the dress and into the full shape with the mesh at the bottom and all that volume that she created. And Ayana's one of those who's very interesting to me, because as a human being, she doesn't really seem to have much personal style, but when she's styling other people, she just has it. And it's almost the exact opposite problem that Samantha had, who went home a couple episodes ago, is that she had really incredible personal style and she created everything that she wore and it all looked great, but then when she designed for other people, something about it just didn't really work. So Ayana's interesting to me. I don't know how much of what she wears that she makes, but she is excellent at creating other people's clothing. Brandon was safe. He was in the top, which I'm furious about. The skirt was very cute, but this is what, the 10th crop top that he's made, and I'm just over it. I'm really tired of it, and I'm tired of him going into every challenge being like, I don't know if I can do this, and then turning out a look flawlessly. It's the exact same look he's done every single week, but it's really starting to wear down of him going in being doubtful of his abilities to do it when he knows what he's capable of. Kentaro was absolutely the most disappointing of the whole night, just of what he created. I don't know what he was thinking. And the quote of the entire episode, which just had me cackling, was, I look like Pocahontas who's about to play football. And that was absolutely the most correct term that could be used. Something was weird about the styling, and everything about it was just a miss, and not even Lyris could save that dress, and she's fabulous. She's the most, I would dare say, she's the most fabulous model that's ever walked down that runway, hands down. Kenya's was really strange because it had like a lumpy butt padding on the side, and she looked like she just had these giant hips, and I don't think I would have been as angry at it if she had almost made it a party dress kind of and cut off that bottom skirt, because she just had this huge silhouette, and I didn't understand why the judges, specifically Nina, kept saying that it had so much dynamicism with that skirt, because I didn't find it particularly interesting, and I thought that she would have been at the bottom, and I did not like what she created. I usually like what Kenya makes, but this one was just not it for me. Margarita's was another one who they loved, and I didn't get it, because it looked like there was a creature on her body, like the bodice part, it looked like those circle things that she had, I forget what those were, it looked like those were eyeballs right on the boobs, and then right underneath it she had a buckle, and it had this circle shape, and it looked like a mouth, and so it looked like this creature that was on her boobs, and I wanted it to have like eyelashes and like a tongue or something, because it just looked like a Muppet or something. It was very off, and I didn't get the superhero reference that they were coming up with. Just the whole thing was a huge miss for me, and I would put her at the bottom as well. And I thought the color really cheapened it, in the same way that I thought the color that Michael used was very cheap. Next week, they are supposed to create high fashion warrior women inspired outfits. And I personally am hoping that Kentaro is gonna do really well. I hope that he pulls from his Japanese influence and creates another kind of samurai type of a look, like he did with, I forget what challenge that was, like two or three episodes ago. I think it was the streetwear challenge. And I think that that could probably benefit him really well in taking it to a very personal cultural place. And I think that that could work out really well in his favor. I'm gonna put my idea in the hat that next week is gonna be the Tim Gunn save, much like how it was in 14. I forget who the designer was when they got all the way to the top five and he had been doing really well the whole season. And then that last episode right before Fashion Week, he just bombed. And then Tim used his save. So I think Tim's gonna use it then. And if they do a top three, it's definitely gonna be Ayana, Brandon, who they flat out said this week that they want to see a full collection that he could make. And I think it could either be Kentaro or Margarita. And I think that Kenya's probably next to go because she's been so hit or miss the whole time. But I would not be mad if Brandon was next to go, just because I'm like, I'm over the crop top thing and I want to see more variety. And so far every episode, that's all we've gotten is crop tops that are oversized and a really cute skirt. And I don't know, I feel like there should be more to a designer than that. Let me know what your thoughts were in the comments below if you watched this episode. If you didn't, I'm sorry I spoiled the whole thing. That's your fault for watching the video. Bye!